Hey computer cooks, welcome to Retro Recipes. So I'm here just with a really quick video because I just read about a noise fix mod that can stop the buzzing of the Commodore 64 SID chip. What buzzing, you say? Can't hear it? How about now? Can you hear it now? The noise is coming from the audio input pin. And because the SID doesn't really use audio input, unless you're trying to digitize the Ghostbusters welcome voice,
Ghostbusters!
Then we can disable that. And all we do is ground it between pins 2 and 5. For 5 of the 8-pin DIN plug. So I'm going to try and do this in under 5 minutes. That means the race is on. Welcome to Retro Recipes. Let's get cooking. I feel like Brendan Fraser. Okay, here she is again, back on my workbench. Just where I like her. Let's open her up. Okay, I haven't even unplugged anything. How's that for speed? So, now I realize I'm pulling everything. So I'm gonna unplug them. As my father used to say, if a job's worth doing, it's worth doing properly. This is an 8-pin DIN plug. It's referred to as a horseshoe variety because it doesn't go in a circle, it kind of goes in a U-shape. So as you can see from the schematic, that's our audio input pin. And that's our ground pin number 2. That is pin 5, and that is pin 2. So all we need to do is bridge those on the inside, and we have therefore grounded pin 5, and hopefully reduced the noise. So when you look at this on the inside, you can see that these are numbered here, so 7 and 8, and you can tell where they go to in the pins as well. Now I've run into my first headache with this. So pin 5 is visible. The pin 2 is all the way inside. I wanted to do this the lazy way without removing the main board. Wait a minute. What did my dad tell me? There we see pin 2 and pin 5. And it should be as simple as bridging those with a little wire. Now, as part of this video, I did interview several wires, and this was the one that won the job. Congratulations, little wire. I'm gonna trim that down a bit so it doesn't impede the others. So I'm gonna just heat this up, add a little more solder on the top. There is our bridged connection. Let's go try it out. And it's still on 20. There it is. Okay, and then on the noisy screen, when the actual SID chip turns on, I have no keyboard. Keyboard. Waiting for the XRGB Mini to boot up. Yeah. Okay. So this is without the pin. And now I'm going to switch immediately and cut to with the pin. Yeah. Right. I think we can call this a minor success. A little humming, a little buzzing reminds us, hey, we were happy with that in 1983. Thank you so much for joining me on this 5-minute journey. As always, please subscribe, support, and share this video. Thank you also to my Patreons for supporting this channel. It really means a lot to me. Till next time, I'll leave you with some nice SID music. Without any noise, cheerio. Ha ha ha!